Okay, here we are with Jimmy Robinson on the Florentina Marine. Is that right?
Florentia.
Florentia Marine, local highlining urchin diver here in Santa Barbara. Tell us a little bit about the diving community around here.
The diving community around here is pretty rich with characters. It's without a doubt. Pretty close-knit, you know, everybody knows everybody. Everybody helps everybody out pretty much.
I'm Zack Robinson. Jimmy Robinson was my dad, a commercial urchin diver who was killed in 1994 by a great white shark.
Shark Lab's been at Cal State Long Beach since 1969. One of our goals is not just study and learn about shark behavior and physiology. The goal is to make that available to the public. In many ways, I look at white sharks as probably the greatest conservation success story California has to offer. I think the white shark populations come back mainly for five reasons. We've protected them, their food sources have come back, we've cleaned up the water, we've managed our fisheries better, and our air quality is better. All those reasons have helped the white shark population recover. For as long as we have records, we have evidence of baby white sharks being in close proximity to our beaches. The Southern California Bight, that area from Santa Barbara down to about the Mexican border, is a well-known nursery for those sharks.
I think about my dad often when I'm working out there. You know, I feel like he's there. He's a part of it all. Whether in spirit or in just being a part of the history and like a figure in this community, in the fishing community here.
I knew Jimmy from the diving industry. We were kind of at the beginning of the whole sea urchin production. You know, it was considered a pest for so long, and then we found a good market that somebody actually wants to eat these things.
Most of them are back here, but that needs to be looked at up there. JP.
Aye, aye, Captain.
And then all this over here, too.
I've been diving for 45 years. Part of my job is to watch for anything that might endanger them, whether it be a shark, a big seal, another boat. You know, there's so many things that can happen that you're not aware of when you're underwater. Jimmy, yeah, Bubblegum. He had a few nicknames, but he was just a fun-loving, hardworking, you know, always going a little deeper, a little bit farther into that shark park.
What's your favorite island dive?
Oh, San Miguel.
Really?
Yeah, I love San Miguel. It's a mysterious spot for sure. There's a lot of energy, a lot of spiritual stuff going on out there, and it's by far probably the most beautiful and probably the most alive with seals.
I remember his son, Zach. His dad used to put him in one of these sea urchin sacks as a young boy, swing him out on the davit and just let him just like him. He definitely kept people smiling. He's one of those kind of people, never too serious.
My dad was well-liked because he was generous and outgoing, and you know, he had style and class. He made a lot of money, never had a dime because he always gave it to his friends or threw parties or bought things for someone. He was down here, you see him step off a fishing boat, and he had a nice silk shirt on and his curly blonde hair and his Rolex watch, and he was a highliner.
Attention on the water.
Attention in the water. This is the Orange County Sheriff's Department to let you know you are paddleboarding next to approximately 15 great white sharks. They're advising that you exit the water in a calm manner. The sharks are as close as the surf line. Thank you for your cooperation.
If you see a shark, calmly and slowly swim to the shore. I'm not sure how calm and slow I would be.
I think my mom's afraid of me swimming in the ocean more than I am afraid of swimming in the ocean myself.
If I saw a shark in the water, I would get my voice out of the water, like right away. My anxiety is like rising right now.
If you spent any amount of time in the water in Southern California over the last 10 to 15 years, chances are an adult white shark swam by you and you didn't even know it. As long as I keep my calm and I keep my wits about me and be cognizant of my environment, I'm pretty safe. So white shark representation in the media is largely has a tinge of fear associated with it. In many ways, I think they're trying to do that for public safety, but the way it's portrayed quite often brings about an air of fear. And that's something that we're trying to dispel.
The media portrayal in the film and TV industry has always been for drama. That's the whole point. You want to watch something entertaining. Unfortunately, that's carried over to the news as well. So on the news, they're always talking about attacks. It's so overblown right now that everybody has a little bit of hesitancy. I know I'm fine when I get in the water, but I still have to tell myself that first. That's a shame. And they're not really attacking you. If a great white shark wants to attack you, you will not survive.
Our friend Jimmy Robinson in December 9th, 1994 was attacked by a white shark out in this area called Shark Park. And it was when he was on the surface and the shark came up from underneath and bit him around the whole midsection and cut his femoral arteries enough to where the bleeding was impossible to stop before he bled out. That sort of image is really hard to get rid of.
I was in boarding school in Washington when I found out. I was up in a friend's room and the dean knocked on the door and called me to his apartment in the dorms, and that doesn't happen. You go to the office. So I was like, what did I get caught for? What did I do? They had me sit down and they handed me the telephone, and my mom told me that my dad had been killed.
The Shark Research Committee I founded in 1963, and our primary objective is to analyze and gather data on shark-human interactions that take place.
A shark attack is defined as any contact between a shark, a human, or a piece of equipment being used by the human. Simply because I'm lying on a surfboard and a shark comes up and hits the surfboard but doesn't hit me, doesn't mean that isn't an aggressive behavior that was directed at that object and at me.
Images like what that were conjured from the book and the movie Jaws have created that monster in our mind, right? So it's created the shark as being this kind of mindless feeding machine and making it dangerous for people to go in the ocean. Even the author of Jaws, Peter Benchley, regretted writing that book because of how people perceive sharks after that. He spent the remaining part of his career actually trying to help save sharks. So he understood the problems that that book created.
The investigation is underway this morning into the circumstances surrounding a dramatic fishing video posted to social media. And we need to warn you, these pictures are very disturbing. This video appears to show a group of men laughing while dragging a captured shark behind a fast-moving motorboat off the coast of Florida.
You know, seeing the people dragging the shark behind the boat, it seemed like the typical beer belly sport fishing type is just wants to have a good time with the boys, and isn't this great fun towing the shark behind the boat and smiling about it. I think it was really sad. I was thinking it'd be really nice to tow them behind the boat by their ankles for a while and see if they, how much they like that. It was just completely uncalled for, very cruel.
I think what I found most impressive about that was the public shaming that happened. I mean, I was truly impressed at how quickly the public was outraged by that, So that's a good sign. That to me shows that there are a lot of people out there that do care about how animals are treated. We have to learn to share the environment with them. Now, it doesn't mean we can't use it too, but we do have to be cognizant of their behavior. And we have to learn how to share it with them without putting us at greater risk or them at greater risk.
Yeah, I do think we can coexist safely with white sharks. Stay out of the water. No, I'm kidding, but I think we can just leave them alone, let them do their thing, and respect them for what they are.
Over the years, I've interviewed probably right around 250 people personally that have been bitten by sharks. Out of that number, only 3-4 of them have, I'm gonna go out and kill a shark. That was their attitude. Everybody else said, hey, it's their home. I was out there, you know, that's a risk I take.
Since the 70s, shark populations have been decimated. And most of that reason is because of people. But at the same time, you don't need to be afraid of it. You're not afraid of getting in your car to go on the highway. You're not afraid of the vending machine you're putting your dollar bill in. You're not afraid of cows. Well, maybe you are. But nonetheless, you don't need to be afraid of sharks.
I hope the next generation of ocean user will get to go in the water and see sharks while they use the ocean and appreciate the importance of those animals and want to protect them. The thing that I'd hope for is that just because a shark swims by somebody, there's no reason for them to freak out or clear the beach or call Channel 7 to report on it. I think it should be one of those things where somebody got out of the water and said, I had an awesome day today. I was out surfing and I saw a white shark.
It's hard for me to be angry about what might happen to my dad. And a big part of me is happy. You know, that's how we wanted to go. That's where he lived, out there with the sharks. He told me as a kid, he wanted to die from a great white shark. And he stood on a table at a party, someone told me, and did a speech and ended it by, he was gonna go out by being bit by a white shark. Yeah, he got in a fight with the scariest creature on the planet. He didn't win, but I'm sure he tried. The harbor here is a tight-knit community. And they've been like uncles to me since I was a baby, a lot of them, and we kind of look after our own. I was mentored into fishing, you know. I've always been a fisherman off and on, but I was given a shot on all these different boats because of who I am and who my dad was. I think we all have our own legacies, and that was his legacy. And yeah, I'm writing my own book, and who knows where it's gonna end.